So dear children, so let's continue the fractional column distillation. So this liquid air is allowed to warm up slowly in the fractional distillation column. So where gases get separated at different heights depending upon the boiling point. So depending upon the boiling point, so we can easily separate the gases. So in that air, what are the gases are there? One is oxygen, nitrogen, and third is argon. Let me see the experimental setup. So this is the experimental setup. So you can see here. So it is a filter, and so in that we have to pass the air, and we have to apply under pressure. So under pressure, the air will goes, and the temperature here is low and the pressure it will be high. So that's why here we have to apply the pressure. So what is the purpose of applying pressure and decrease the temperature? Yes, the air is converted to liquid air. So that's why we have to increase the pressure and decrease the temperature. So the hot air it will comes here, and here the fractionating column is there, and in that the water circulation will be there. And so here there is a separator is there, so in that the cold compressed air it will comes, and here the liquid air is converted here. So the air is converted here as the liquid air. So by applying the pressure, we have to increase the pressure and decrease the temperature, so with the help of condensation. So what is the purpose of condensation? Yes, to avoid the decomposition. So here we have to do the condensation process. And so here it is, a separator is there, and the liquid air is goes inside. So the air is now separated accordingly with that boiling point. So here you can see the nitrogen gas is comes out here at the top, and that argon gas is comes out in the bottom, and here you can see the oxygen. So the liquid oxygen is comes here. So with the help of fractional distillation, we can separate the air. So what are the mixture present in air? Yes, oxygen, nitrogen, and argon. Next, you can see, so how can we obtain pure copper sulfate from an impure sample? So how we can get the pure copper sulfate from an impure copper sulfate? So what is the formula for copper sulfate? CuSO4. So how can we get the pure copper sulfate? Let me see the activity 2.9. So in that, so we have to take some approximately around 5 gram of impure sample of copper sulfate in a china dish. So we have to take the copper sulfate in one china dish, and so dissolve it in minimum amount of water. So we have to dissolve the copper sulfate with minimum amount of water, and we have to filter the impurities out. If there is any impurities, means we can filter it first. So we have to filter the impurities with the help of filter paper, and evaporate water from the copper sulfate solution so as to get a saturated solution. So after the filtration, we have to evaporate. At the time of evaporate, the water will comes out, and copper sulfate solution is there. So it is in to get to convert it to the saturated solution. So saturated solution means it will not completely soluble in that water component. And so after the copper sulfate is converted to saturated solution, So cover the solution with a filter paper and leave it undisturbed at room temperature to cool slowly for a day. So we have to cover the saturated solution with the help of filter paper and we have to cool for one day at room temperature. No need to disturb that apparatus. So you may obtain the crystals of copper sulfate in the china dish. So after one day, if you see that saturated solution of copper sulfate, so you can see the crystals of copper sulfate, the fine crystals are there. You can see that. So this process is called crystallization. So crystallization is nothing but to purify the component. So actually when we synthesize the compound, in chemistry lot of research work is goes on now. So for that we have to synthesize the compound and after the synthetic compound, so we have to do the crystallization. So what is the purpose of crystallization? Yes, to convert the impure component to pure component. So that is the main purpose of crystallization. So the crystallization methods is used to purify solids. So if the given component is solid, means we can purify with the help of crystallization. For example, the salt we get from sea water can have many impurities in it. For example, in the sea water we can get the salt. So in that, lot of impurities are there, no? So how we can remove the impurities? Yes, with the help of crystallization process. And to remove the impurities, the process of crystallization is used. So how we can remove the impurities? With the process. So what is the process? Crystallization process. So crystallization is the process that separates a pure solid in the form of its crystal from a solution. So first we have to take the impure compound and we have to add minimum amount of water and we have to boil it. So the term of boil, it will convert it to saturated solution and after we have to cover with the help of filter paper. So we no need to disturb for one day. So after one day you can see the fine crystals on is obtained in the china dish. And the crystallization technique is better than simple evaporation technique as. So simple evaporation technique, when we go for simple evaporation, so on that they, we can't able to get the pure compound. But when we go for crystallization, we can get the pure compound. So some solids decompose or some like sugar may get char on heating to dryness. So some solid it may be decompose. So when we heat that sugar, so what does it form? The charring smell, it will be there. We may get charred on heating to dryness and some impurities may remain dissolved in the solution even after filtration. So when we dissolve filtration, there are some impurities will be there, but in the crystallization we can get the pure component. So on evaporation, these contaminate the solid. So when we go for evaporation, the contamination will take place. Application. So what are the applications of crystallization? So purification of salt that we get from sea water. First application is we can purify the salt from sea water. And second application is separation of crystals of alum from impure sulfate. So we can separate the crystals of alum, and those by choosing one of the above methods accordingly to the nature of the component of mixture, we can get the pure substance. So with the help of crystallization, we can get the pure substance. So with advancement in technology, many more methods of separation techniques have been devised. In cities, drinking water is supplied from water works. So in cities you can see the drinking water. So for the drinking water, there are various methods are there to purify the drinking water. Let me see that. So you can see here, so it's a receiver. So in that, the water is there. So first it will pass to the sedimentation tank. So in that sedimentation tank, if there is any solid particles are there, means it will settle here. It's a sedimentation tank. And next, it's a loading tank. So in that, to sediment the suspended impurities. So here, the impurities, it will settle down. And after that, it will pass to the filtration tank. So in the filtration tank, so you can see at the bottom, it is a gravel, it will be there, and fine sand is there, and further only we have to pass the water. So in that, if there is any minute impurities are there, means it will settle at the bottom. So after that, it's a chlorination. So what is the purpose of chlorination? To kill the bacteria. So in the tank we have to apply the chlorine powder. If there is any bacteria is there, means it will kill. And after that, the water, it will be goes to the home. So it is here. Water purification system. So how the water is purified, and we will see the various separation methods now. Let me summarize it. The first technique, that is two miscible liquids, example oil and water. So what is the technique is used? Yes, with the help of separating funnel. So the immiscible liquids, two immiscible liquids means separating funnel. The miscible liquids means distillation process. And ammonium chloride plus sand. So ammonium chloride is volatile substance. It will easily vaporize. For that, what is the separation techniques is used? Sublimation. And next is dyes in black ink. One solvent, different constituents, dye in black ink. So in that, there are, it will have the two or more different colors are there. If two or more different colors are there, means we can go for the chromatographic technique. And next is two miscible liquids. So two miscible liquids is acetone plus water. So what is the separation method? Yes, it is distillation. And last type of mixture is solid particles insoluble from liquid, that is milk plus cream. So what is the method is used? Yes, centrifugation. And next we can go for the physical change and chemical change. So what is my physical change? So physical change means, so in that, there is an appearance, it will be changed. The color, shape, size is changed. But in chemical change, the complete transformation is there. So we can't able to retain them into the initial state. And physical change is reversible. So we can retain them into initial state. So for example, when you go